Drawing of a man writing.
4,000 years after the advent of reading and writing,
a 12-year-old boy created a system for people who are blind to become literate.
In this edition of Today in Technology,
we visit the childhood home of Louis Braille in France to learn more about how he created this unique and time-tested method of reading.
A woman reading Braille.
Then we head back to Microsoft, where we connect history to the present
and learn what it means to develop technology that's accessible for all.
Typeset Braille. Text Today in Technology, building on the legacy of Louis Braille. Outside the Louis Braille Museum, Couvray, France. Welcome to the Louis Braille Museum.
People
Let's
who
go
are
in.
Blind
Thank you.
All over the world benefit every day because of what happened in this house. Can you tell us what makes it so special?
Carol Ann Brown and Brad Smith with Farida Sadi Hamid. 4,000 years after the birth of writing, the blind finally had a system of writing. Louis Braille lived in this house with his family during the 19th century. He is the godfather for people who are blind.
Can you describe what the Braille system is?
Louis Braille is 12 years old. He's going to create an alphabet. Then all the letters with accents, all the numbers, all the punctuation marks, a system of reading with using fingers. He said that's the solution. In 1825, Louis Braille finishes his system and publishes his first book, which presents his system of reading and writing. Braille started to be used. It would spread throughout the world, just like writing did for sighted people. We can't imagine the place and importance of Louis Braille in the life and in the heart of people who are blind. In their history, in their humanity, there is before and after Louis Braille. How does the spirit of Louis Braille live on in today's innovators? Redmond, Washington, with Brad Smith, another man, points a smartphone toward Carol Ann.
How about I try it on you?
Sure.
All right, so let's try.
Processing. 38-year-old woman with blonde hair looking happy.
Is it diplomatic or?
Totally.
People love that.
Completely accurate.
Anirudh Kaul, senior data scientist, Microsoft.
So Seeing AI is a talking camera app. It speaks what it sees, and it harnesses the power of artificial intelligence to narrate the visual world in an auditory experience. This is designed for the blind and low vision community, but it's inclusive design, so there are more uses than we ever imagined. Can you read a greeting card that's handwritten? We said, let's give it a try.
Processing. Thank you for the flowers, I love you.
Can you tell us a bit about the initial development phase?
Every year in the company, we have an event called the hackathon. It's a week long to work on any project that you desire. So we made a team, brainstormed on the problem. Our very first prototype was a MacGyver-like cell phone duct taped to the head, which you could ask questions and it would look and speak to you.
People with phones at foreheads.
As you continue to work on this, what is it that motivates you?
My grandfather, who was a professor, a lifelong educator, an avid reader, with old age, he would have a hard time recognizing my face. So that got me involved in this, met like-minded folks in the company. It has been a dream journey for us.
Shannon Carey.
So when we're developing products for people who are blind or visually impaired, what should we keep in mind?
There's a common saying in the disability community, you shouldn't build anything for us without including us. And that's incredibly important because when that happens, you get a better outcome in terms of product functionality being something that people really value and use.
He reads Braille.
When I think about Braille, I think it was one of the first tools that was created that helped people who were blind understand the broader world around them. It provided that first level of solid independence. And if you look at things like Seeing AI, those are also tools that enable that independence that's so important for people of all kinds. It just makes my life more efficient.
A bust of Louis Braille.
So we're always learning from the past.
Jenny Leifleur.
What will the future bring?
News articles.
Biggest program that just gets me jumping out of bed in the morning is AI for Accessibility. This is a grant program to build technology for people with disabilities leveraging AI solutions. It's a $25 million investment over the next 5 years. I just get so excited at the potential of what that will bring.
We're continuing to innovate. We're continuing to look for opportunities for technology to help people with disabilities. We can build on Louis Braille's success, and as we do, we build on that legacy.
Microsoft.